Vancouver Point Grey.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Honorable Speaker, when the amount of the Premier's $50,000 a year stipend finally became public, the Premier had a strong defender, and I'm not talking about the leader of the BC Green Party.
But he could have been.
Peter Brown, longtime BC Liberal Party fundraiser, couldn't see any problems with the Premier taking home $300,000 over 5 years from donations made to the BC Liberal Party. Now, that same Mr. Brown just sold his mansion in Vancouver for $31.1 million, $5.6 million over the assessed value. He sold it, Honorable Speaker, to a student. Now, when hardworking families see that the very person defending the Premier's stipend, making tens of thousands of dollars in donations to the Premier's BC Liberal Party, selling his home for $31.1 million to a student, all while the finance minister says, nothing to see here in the Metro Vancouver housing market, they ask the question, is this government willfully blind to what's happening in the Metro Vancouver housing market because their donors like it that way?
Minister of Finance.
Thanks, Madam Speaker. Let me offer up for the member and members something that I am eminently familiar with out in the part of the province that I call home, the Eastern Fraser Valley. I can name at least six families who have made this decision, whose children or child want to attend the Vancouver Film School or UBC, and they make the decision to purchase a home for that child. And it represents an investment. Well,
members,
and Madam Speaker, they make that decision as a family, and it represents an investment and a home for that child to live in. Now, the members and the member appears offended by that notion. And Madam Speaker, beyond that, I would suggest it's time for the member to get beyond the generalities. We've increased the property transfer tax, and I'm not going to comment on any specific transaction, but I can tell members this. On a $31 million purchase and sale, the property transfer tax is now, as a result of the increase that was included in the budget, nearly $1 million. Now, the member, as he is entitled, presumably doesn't think that's enough. So if he wants to be taken seriously, why doesn't he stand up, because he's got another crack at it, and tell us what he thinks is enough? Tell us how much the vacancy tax that he would propose to impose is going to be. Tell British Columbians how much the speculation tax that he keeps talking about is going to be. Stop lurching from idea to idea in abstract and give British Columbians some specifics, Madam Speaker.
Vancouver Point Grey on a supplemental.
Honourable Speaker, I was hoping for the first time since I've been here that the Premier would stand up and talk about her commitment to providing student housing.
That won't happen. That's
too expensive.
Now, Honourable Speaker, this Finance Minister says, no problem. No problem in Metro Vancouver's housing market, but a new study released yesterday says couples between the ages of 25 and 35 years old in Vancouver have the lowest discretionary income of anywhere in Canada. So low, it's actually negative, Honourable Speaker. Couples in the same age group in Victoria, the third lowest discretionary income of anywhere in Canada. Choosing to live in almost any other city in Canada means an extra $10,000 or more in discretionary income. To the Premier.
Members.
I don't know, is this a joke for the government, Honourable Speaker?
Members.
Really? You might want to tell that to
housing crisis for families is not a joke.
As long as the donors are happy, Honourable Speaker. To the Premier, who needs $240,000 a year to live in Metro Vancouver, how can she defend two of the three lowest discretionary income cities in Canada, being British Columbia?
Minister of Finance.
Madam Speaker, it is regrettable that the member appears to want merely to deal in the abstract and not provide actual facts.
Members.
That was the voter's decision, wasn't it?
You know, it's Madam Speaker, not the first time I have heard the opposition propose tax increases for British Columbians and not want to tell them how much. Because that, of course, is what they are proposing. But look, back to good news, Madam Speaker. Stats can.
This House will come to order. Proceed.
Thanks, Madam Speaker. Because Stats can has posted their numbers for the country in terms of economic growth. And for 2015, confirmed that not only has Canada, as British Columbia, led the nation again, we are almost three times the national rate at 3% economic growth, Madam Speaker. I know the member for jobs was talking about that yesterday when she spoke at the Canadian Building Trust. I'm sure members of the opposition who were there would have heard.
Oh,
of course, they weren't there because they weren't invited, Madam Speaker.
Vancouver Point Grey on a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker.
Members. Members. Please continue.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Now, you know, this minister has a lot of questions. He'll have a lot of time to ask questions when he and his government are sitting on this side of the House. Our secret agenda in a private member's bill that the government can call any day if they'd like to pass it. Now, according to this finance minister, everything's under control, everything's normal. So a normal real estate market for this government is one where a student can scrape together $5.6 million over the assessed value and pay $31.1 million for a house in Vancouver. Now, that's a market where the average 25 to 35-year-old The average 25 to 35-year-old in Metro Vancouver, Honourable Speaker, has negative income. Now, Honourable Speaker, if this is all systems normal for this government, I don't know what information it's going to take to convince them otherwise. So the Finance Minister says he's going to study the market himself personally and let us know if he sees a problem. Well, what information, Honourable Speaker, in his study will convince him that there's a problem with affordability in Metro Vancouver's housing market?
Minister of Finance.
Look, Madam Speaker, and to the member, I don't want to leave the incorrect impression. I quite enjoy the exchange with the Dauphin of the NDP. Well, now I am troubled, Madam Speaker. Look, there is clearly a market dynamic at play that I think is of concern to people in particularly one part of British Columbia. And there seem to be emerging two theories around approach to that, and I have acknowledged this openly. I and the government believe that primarily where the focus should be is on improving supply and reducing some of the pressure that accrues from having way more people looking for a finite product. The opposition, from what I can gather, Madam Speaker, takes a very different view. The member's colleague yesterday from Mount Pleasant in very clear terms described it as a demand problem. And it seems the opposition, given the chance, would address that in the way that the NDP traditionally addresses that. They would raise taxes and create an economy that discourages people from coming to British Columbia. We think that's the wrong approach, Madam Speaker.